Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss the point paraphrasing, which is again it is from the unit number 4. Unit number 4, it is having the objective as to develop the communication skills. So paraphrasing, the word which is considered in that paraphrase, it is nothing but restatement of that particular equivalent sentence having the same meaning, right? That means you are reproducing whatever the phrase or paragraph, but in your own word, right? This is the concept of this particular paraphrasing. Paraphrasing, again, you can say that, suppose I am written one phrase, right? So this, whatever I am written that particular phrase, it can be translated in others style, because I am written this phrase in my style, I use my own words, right? The same phrase can be translated without having any change in the meaning, change in that particular subject. It is translated in another person's or another style by using his, that person's words, right? That is a concept. It is nothing but the paraphrasing. So this one of the person, that means researcher or that particular writer, he said that paraphrase, it is nothing but it may be, by using this paraphrase, it may be happens that whatever the, your English communication is there, it may be goes in a wrong way, that is bad. But it is not the, that exact case. As per his statement, it is the not the case. You are exercising on your, you can say that, that English language, and you are trying to improve your English communication by using the paraphrasing concept. That is the concept of this particular paraphrasing. Just I said that paraphrasing, it is nothing but what you are doing, you are converting that particular, translating that particular paragraph or passage or that particular point, topic, in from your word to the another person's word. That means that person, he is converting that thing. Suppose I have one topic which is written by the other person, right? I will read that particular passage, that topic, and I will try to convert that particular passage without changing its that meaning, but I am using the some sort of the my own style with the some sort of the words. Might be in this case it is not necessary to consider the sentence sequence which is previously in that particular original passage. It is not the the thing. We are not going to copy that particular you can say that the sentence format, the grammatical concept, all that thing. We are just understanding that particular idea and the concept of that particular phrase, the subject of that particular passage, and again converting in our style without changing the meaning of that particular passage. This concept is called as the paraphrasing. See, it is the reproduction of that without changing the meaning of that particular passage, writing the in that particular sentences. Right? Once again, I am repeating that thing. Paraphrasing, it is nothing but you are reproducing the sentences which are not changing the meaning of the previous one, previous phrase one, or previous paragraph. But this thing, it is also said that paraphrasing, it is not like that particular summarizing or phrase, passage writing. It is not the that case. Passage writing or summarizing the that particular paragraph, it is not same as that particular, you can say that, paraphrasing. Because I am saying that paraphrasing is nothing but you are translating one style to the another style of that particular passage, of that particular paragraph, right? But without changing the that particular style. Then what exactly uses of this particular paraphrase is there. The first uses is that you will get the exercise on that particular composition. This is the, you can say that first use. That means people can get the ability to practice on that particular, understand that particular, how to read that particular passage and how to recompose that particular passage in their own language. Right, this is the, you can see that one of the excellent method to, you can see that read and that particular, convert that particular form of that particular topic in other words or other, you can say that style, instead of word you can use the style. Right, this is the one, you can say that point from the this use. Another it is that it secondly it is what it is doing, it is giving the fine training on the art of expression. That means in paraphrasing you are understanding the concept and you are writing in your own words, in your own style, but without changing the that particular previous meaning. Right, without changing the previous meaning. Might be in this case what happens, some that paragraph may get increased, but no doubt. But you will get the excellent, you can say that experience for the reading and getting that particular, writing that particular point. That is the thing. Second use of this paraphrase is that how to explain this particular paragraph, it will get the idea from this particular paraphrase. You can say that you will get trained in this particular explaining the topic because you are converting in your own style. This is the second use, right? So this is the, you can see that main two uses of this particular paraphrase. Now for the exactly characteristics of this particular paraphrasing, good paraphrasing, it be considered one. See, there are few, you can see that characteristics are there. First is the translation. That means you have to translate that particular specifics of the paragraph in a paraphrasing. Specifics of that particular passage or that paragraph in that paraphrasing. That means you have to translate entire the thing, but in your own style. It is not considered that you are converting that translation in the sense what you are doing. You are only changing the style. Not you are translating from one language to another language. That may be English from Tamil or English from Hindi. It is not the case. That is the translation. Fullness. Paragraph differs from the summarizing or you can see that precise writing because it is not the, you can see that I already shared that it is not the, you can say that same to that precise writing or summarizing, or you can say that passage writing, it is not the case. You are only making changing the style and you are writing that particular, reproducing that particular paragraph in your own style, in your own style by using some sort of the other words. That is the thing. So fullness in the sense you have to consider all that particular original things, ideas behind that particular paragraph, and by using that thing you have to write which will not left, or you can see that any miss the point from this particular paraphrasing writing. That is the fullness. Wholeness, same concept, it is considered that particular thing whatever I just discussed, that by considering the original in this paraphrasing, sentence by sentence, we are not considering from original paragraph. Sentence by sentence, word by word, it is not the case. But complete thing it is considered from that particular original paragraph, and it is understand one by reading more times. It is understand what exactly that particular person want to, or that particular main writer, he want to say about that point. It should be understand one properly. For that we are reading it is carefully, and whole thing we are translating in a our style. Wholeness it should be there, and completeness, That means to produce the good paraphrasing, we have to, without missing any thing, we have to produce one, and we have to, before finalizing, we have to reread, or we have to read more than one time, so that any grammatical mistake, punctuations, or that particular, you can say that sequence of that particular sentence, it will not be, you can say that, affecting on the finalization of that particular paraphrasing point or that particular paragraph. Paraphrasing that particular paragraph, it should not be there. There should not be any miss thing happen with that particular thing. Any mistake should not be happening in this particular thing. That care it is taken under this particular complete precise of the prose. That is the main thing. Got this thing? This is the, you can see that some sort of the characteristics it is utilized. These are the some of the characteristics which are utilized while paraphrasing any paragraphs, which is you are not, you can say that you are not summarizing, you are not writing a story. You are, that means small story, or you are coming from that particular thing and you are what the points are there. It is not the case, right? That is the thing. So paraphrasing, it is the thing. Okay, paraphrasing, it can be considered not only the paragraph, it can be considered from the any poetry, right? And for that, in that poetry also, while considering the poetry, we have to read that poetry carefully. In that particular poetry, what exactly it is they are giving the message from that poetry, we have to understand it. That idea we have to grasp over. The words, some words are there which are not used in a regular communication, but some words it is considered in a poetry. That word we have to understand one. And that word again we have to convert in our style, and accordingly to the, without hampering the meaning of that particular poem, we have to write the that particular paraphrase. We have to complete that particular paraphrase. Getting my point? Because sometimes what happens, that poetry, whatever it is using that sentences, or whatever the poem it is written in that particular, maybe you can see that that word arrangement, it is a different one, right? In a different manner that word it is arranged. We have to understand that particular arrangement. Some additional words which are not regularly used one, that is also considered one. We have to understand that words also. And according to that concept, understanding the meaning of that word, understanding the that idea behind that particular poem, and what exactly he want to say, give the message from that particular poem. By considering this thing, we have to write the this particular paraphrasing. We have to do the paraphrasing on the poem, right? And which gives some additional, you can say that, experience while writing this particular paraphrasing from the poetry, right? So this care it should be taken while converting that poem into the paraphrasing concept. Here some points are given: difference in words, difference in the order of the words, and flurry and arithmetical language, and rhythm and rhyme. These things should not be copied from the, you can see that, poem in the our style, our paraphrasing style. Because rhythm it is considered in poem, we should not be copy that particular thing in the writing that particular style of that paraphrasing. But by considering this point, it is not necessary to change the meaning of that particular poem. If it is done, then it is not called the paraphrasing. Okay, it is not called as a paraphrasing. Paraphrasing is also not the thing that you are reading that particular paragraph and you are considering the same grammar, same sentences, and you are writing only in your language. No, that is also not the case. You have to consider that particular thing, but you have to write in your own style. So paraphrasing, once again I am repeating that, once style, word and that particular style, it can be translated in another's words and style. okay, which is giving the, which can be understandable by that particular reader easily. And for that thing, you have to use the English communication in a proper, simple and English, proper English language for this particular writing the paraphrasing. So, for this particular paraphrasing, you have to take care about the English, simple English language. You have to consider the punctuations. You have to consider that particular grammatical things, spelling mistake. You have to consider all these things, and then you have to finalize the whatever the that particular written that paraphrasing in the thing. So here some special hints are given for that particular paraphrasing, so that it will give the some additional experience while writing the paraphrasing. See, direct and indirect speech, that thing you have to consider in a proper way, so that it will not change the meaning of that particular main sentence. Metaphors you have to consider while dealing this particular paraphrasing concept. You have to consider that thing, right? Abstract and use of concurrent things you have to consider in your writing that particular thing, writing in the paraphrasing. Some rhetorical questions you have to consider in your language if it is considered in that original one. Okay, explanations and apostrophes, whatever I discussed previously one, that means grammatical punctuations, that spelling mistake, whatever I shared, okay, that thing it is considered in a, in these particular hints. So exclamations, apostrophes, grammatical things we have to consider in a proper way, so that you can write that particular whatever the poem, either poem or that particular paragraph in your own language, okay, in your own style, not only language, in your own style, with using your own words, your own style and your own language, you can convert that particular one's, other person's passage or paragraph in your own or in your that particular style, you can convert that particular thing. Okay, got this thing? This is the paraphrasing. Okay, if you are having any doubt related to it, you can ask me anytime. Thank you.